What's up, YouTube? I'm G Infinite. Today I'm going to be discussing a little bit about Apocalypse. I'm going to talk about three different figures today. Two of them being from Toy Biz, one of them being a Build-A-Figure from Toy Biz, and the newest Apocalypse Build-A-Figure by Hasbro. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. This is the episode on the X-Men's foe known as Apocalypse. All right, the first figure I'm going to be discussing is the Toy Biz exclusive Build-A-Figure Apocalypse. This Apocalypse is really, really tall. It's about 12 and a half inches tall. And I like what they did. Toy Biz brought out this Apocalypse and they decided, let's make a big Apocalypse, a huge Apocalypse. And he looks really, really cool. He's part of Marvel Legends. And one of the things that I noticed about him is the different tones of blue. If you notice on the chest piece he has a almost like a mute dark blue, and then on the legs it goes into a lighter blue, if you can tell. I also like the fact that on the belt they gave him the A for Apocalypse. Apocalypse has been around for a long time. For those of you that don't know, Apocalypse is the enemy of the X-Men. And he is probably said to be known as the first mutant that ever walked the earth, which we're not sure. But he is definitely one of the foes of the X-Men, just like Thanos is for the Avengers. This Apocalypse, another feature that I liked is the gray that they gave the face. For those of you that don't know, throughout the comics, Apocalypse has always had gray skin. So they gave him that gray, and then they gave him the red in the eyes. And of course, they made him look semi-futuristic. He does have some robot celestial armor. And if you can notice, Mr. Sinister, who is one of the scientists who helped Apocalypse gain strength and become extremely, extremely strong, because Apocalypse is one of those characters that believe survival of the fittest. But if you notice, he also has in the hands some gray gauntlets, and the hands can shift shape into different weapons. And that's one of the things that I like about Apocalypse. Apocalypse also has the ability to grow in size and shrink in size based on how angry he gets. He can actually get larger. If you notice, he also has the tentacles in the back. Those produce some sort of energy that radiates and makes Apocalypse either taller or smaller. I like what they did with the boots. In the bottom, they gave it that darker blue with the silver, with the chrome silver on the boots. And if you noticed, he has some type of bolts on the side of the feet, just to give you a glimpse of his armor. This is what really makes Apocalypse extremely strong and definitely a foe to be reckoned with as far when it comes to the X-Men. This is Apocalypse by Toy Biz. The next Apocalypse I'm going to be talking about is the Apocalypse by Toy Biz from Series 7. This Apocalypse comes with an X-Factor comic book. For those of you that don't know, Apocalypse made his first appearance in an X-Factor comic, and I like this Apocalypse. He's a lot smaller, but they made him very bulky. Like I said, Apocalypse can become either larger or smaller, so they decided to go with a regular size 6-inch figure for this Apocalypse. And I like what they did with Apocalypse. They definitely gave him, if you notice on the legs, he has that metallic, almost like these metal mesh right here over here going down, kind of like showing you that he does have some futuristic abilities to time travel and do all these other things, because Apocalypse has been around for so long. He knows that he's just waiting for the right time to strike, so he believes in world dominance and so forth. Apocalypse has a group. His group is composed of four people who are also have the same views as he does. But this figure in particularly, what I like about it is that the hands are movable. And also, if you look at the face, they did a really good job with the face. They made him look very mean. Gave Apocalypse a really, really good look. The body is very bulky. And I just like the fact that they gave him the legs. If you notice on the legs, they made him very muscular. So just a really good look to Apocalypse. This is by Toy Biz, and this is from the Series 7 Marvel Legends. The next figure I'm going to be talking about was the highly anticipated new X-Men Marvel Legends Build-A-Figure by Hasbro. Now, this is Hasbro's first Apocalypse Build-A-Figure, and one of the reasons why I like this figure is definitely because of the colors that they gave this Apocalypse. The only critique I have about this figure is that I wish he could have been more larger in scale, kind of like the Toy Biz Build-A-Figure. I expected him to be just a lot bigger in size, but this Apocalypse is really, really well done. The only thing is that the hands don't have that flexibility, and so they can't open or close. He just stays in that closed fist position. But he is very poseable. What I like about this Apocalypse is the tones. They gave him that metallic blue with that navy dark blue on the armor guards. If you can see on his upper armor guards, it's that navy blue color. And then of course in the chest piece, it's that metallic blue, which is really, really a nice look. I also like the fact of the head sculpt. They made him look really, really tough, really mean. Apocalypse looks there like he's ready to take out the X-Men, and it's just a really nice and well done sculpted figure. I just wanted it to be a lot larger like the Toy Biz one, but they did a good job. Hasbro did a really well job with this figure. The flexibility in the hands of opening and closing, they could have done that as well, because the Toy Biz ones, the hands do open and close. I like what they did with the hands, the gauntlets on the hands. They gave it that navy blue, and they kept the silver, so you can tell on the inside there, you can see the silver, and it's just, he looks really strong. Apocalypse can change his hands appearance into any kind of weapons. So this is a really, really neat feature that they gave him. I also like the boots. They did the boots very similar to the Apocalypse from the Toy Biz Wave. And one thing that I like about the boots is that they went really dark with the boots, and they kept the silver also on the boots. So this is the Hasbro Apocalypse. Like I said, guys, I like the figure. I think it's well sculpted. I just wanted it to be in a larger scale, but of course Hasbro did come out with this Build-A-Figure. This is from the X-Men Wave that brings Magneto, Wolverine, Gladiator, Sabretooth, Storm, Multiple Man, and Psylocke. So these are some of the figures that it took to build Apocalypse. This is a very cool, neat figure. It's well done. The head sculpt is amazing. And this is Apocalypse by Hasbro Build-A-Figure. All right, guys. So I'm G Infinite. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode on Apocalypse, one of the many foes of the X-Men. And please subscribe, hit us with a like, and hit that bell for the next notification. Peace out, YouTube.